Hello, this is Dread, and in today's video topic, we are going to be talking about Machine Gun Curse Warlock. So, this is not going to be a full build guide for a few reasons, mainly because the build is bugged in a few ways, which we will talk about in a moment. But let's talk about how we got here. So, after having a little bit of a palate cleanser of playing like Shaman or Paladin, right? Now we can play the OP class Warlock. So I was like, all right, let's have some fun with that, right? And we ended up leveling one up and we tried Spine of Maltros and it is bugged to the absolute extreme. No idea what's going on there. So we ended up dipping that. So we moved on into kind of a different idea. So we utilize the staff, the one that makes Hungering Soul Shotgun, which normally, can't do that much damage after the nerf. Now it deals 41% less damage, right? But what's really cool though is it provides us with a lot of hits. I think right now on average we get like 11 hits per click, which is very strong for specifically Warlock, and that is because mainly Bone Curse. So of course Bone Curse does its damage every single time, you hit an enemy. Right, and we're hitting them 11 times, so they take the Bone Curse damage 11 times in a row every single time we right click them. Now, normally, this is okay, this has been an okay build. Like, there are builds that like push this to the absolute extreme, but for the most part, it's like good enough, right? But Warlock comes in and pushes it to the absolute extreme, and that is because of the new curse Anguish. So, the way Anguish normally works is you apply it to a bunch of enemies, right? And whenever those enemies die, they deal necrotic flat damage crit to the rest of the enemies that are applied with, of course, Anguish. And this is really strong as you kill one enemy and then the next enemy gets hit with Anguish, then so on and so forth. And you can kill entire packs very easily with Anguish procs. Now, what you're supposed to do though is on a single target, you're supposed to utilize the No Duskbringer, where you apply Anguish to a single target and then proc it whenever you hit a boss or a rare. And of course, this synergizes very well alongside Bone Curse. We can run stuff like Wither, which gives us a bunch of increased damage on bosses. We can run flat damage with curses, which makes up for the fact that we're utilizing the base, the staff for Curse of Perseverance. It has like very low flat damage, so being able to make up for that fact with, of course, a lot of flat from our gear and stuff like that, that definitely makes the build a lot better. But there's one big problem, one gigantic issue. For some reason, I do not know why. It took me a while to figure this out, by the way. Duskbringer, whenever you finish a monolith, it just stops working. It just stops working. It literally just stops working instantly. On stream the other day, I was playing this build and I was trying to figure out what in the heck was going on. I was trying to figure out like why is my build not functioning? And it turns out that was the case. My build legitimately wasn't functioning because of a bug. Because I'd finish a monolith echo, and then all of a sudden my Anguish procs were no longer working, which is a large majority of our clear and damage on top of our Bone Curse, right? So essentially, I was playing with half of a build constantly yesterday, and that led to a lot of frustration. And then later that evening, I played even more and more. And then what time is it now? 5 a.m. Yeah, I've been up all night trying to figure this shit out. So you should leave a like on the video, by the way. For that. But since we're in bug testing mode, I was like, screw it, let's try to figure out this in more detail. And it turns out if you rezone to like town or to a different place, as long as it's like not in the Monolith of Fate, and then come back, Anguish is okay until the next monolith completion. So if I do a boss, I can go in and re-enable Anguish, stuff like that. But that means every single monolith that I want to do and every single boss I want to do, I have to rezone back to town and then, of course, come back to the monolith. And then I have to go through another loading screen. And then it becomes very, very, very tedious very, very quickly. I tried it. I tried playing it for a little bit. I tried doing the stupid loading screen stuff and. Oh, it drained my sanity so fast. I don't know if you can tell on the tone of my voice, but I've been up for a very long time trying to make this work, and we finally figured out what the bug is. Hopefully, EHG fixes it eventually. I would heavily suggest not playing this build until then. I think it might have enough scaling into endgame. It's a little cool. I am going to leave a planner down in the description. Like I said, this is not going to be like a full build guide or anything, to be honest, right? Because, you know, the bug, as you can tell in the footage, like, it's an okay build. I think it'll scale into endgame pretty well. It's just kind of sad that, like, the Curse Warlock, right, utilizing curses in a cool way, in a very interesting way, just had to be bugged, right? And it had to be a negative bug. You know, we have so many bugs that are just making certain builds absolutely insane, like, you know, the ward bug and stuff like that with Profane Veil, right? But then you have one negative bug, and it happens to be the build that I play right after trying to play with Spine of Maltros, which is also bugged. So, yeah, Dread can never stay away from bugs. They always haunt him in his dreams. And I will say this has been some of the best and worst times I've ever played Last Epoch. I absolutely love this build to death. I love the concept. I love the idea. I love the machine gun action from the Hungering Souls. Like, I love all the proccing of the crits, all the numbers. I love it all. But you know what I don't love? Being gaslighted into thinking that my build is trash because every single time I finished a monolith zone and objective, my build essentially turns off, right? Or having to rezone every single time. That means that every single time I want to do a map or anything, I have to log in. Like, I have to, like, essentially go through three different loading screens. And the loading screens in this game are okay. They're a lot better than they were last patch, but they definitely aren't pretty for the most part. So, yeah. Yeah, like I said, I would go more in detail with this build, but it's definitely, definitely not worth my sanity. Hopefully this is like a short video. With all that being said, this has been Dread. Make sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe to the channel. That'll at least soothe my sanity. I will return to this at one point. I'm going to be respecing this Warlock and playing a different Warlock build since, you know, I already have a Warlock leveled. Might as well try something else. I did have a lot of fun with Soul Feast with this build, which is probably what I'm going to end up playing. All that being said, this has been Dread. I have to go regain a little bit of my sanity. Bye.